Now, it came to pass at that time when Eli was laid down in his place, his eyes began to wax dim that he could not see. And ere the lamp of God went out in the temple of the Lord, where the ark of God was, and Samuel was laid down to sleep. And remember, the high priest was to take care of the lamp. And he put oil in it, and now it is burnt down and about to go out. That the Lord called Samuel, and he answered, "Here am I." And he ran unto Eli and said, "Here am I, for thou callest me." And he said, "I call not. Lie down again." He went and lay down. He just thought the young man was just dreaming, you know, and had a dream. He said, "Go lie down." And the Lord called yet again, "Samuel." Samuel arose and went to Eli and said, "Here am I, for thou didst call me." And he answered, "I call not, my son. Lie down again." Now, we need to note something here, for these first two calls are a call to salvation. Their last two calls, God called him four times, by the way, and the last two are for service. The first two for salvation. Notice verse 7. Now Samuel did not yet know the Lord, neither was the word of the Lord yet revealed unto him. So at this time, Samuel is being called to salvation. He didn't know the Lord, and God is calling him to salvation. Now, what is the age of accountability? I think he had reached that, and that God now is going to hold him responsible. Well, in Israel, we've already seen in the book of Numbers, it was 20 when God called them to war, when a man was able to go to war. And then the Levites didn't begin service till they were 25, and the priests at age 30. Well, how old was Samuel? Well, I do not know how old he was. I could make a suggestion to you, and I may or may not be right, by the way. Over in Numbers, the 14th chapter, verse 29, let me read this. He says, "Your carcasses shall fall in this wilderness, and all that were numbered of you according to your whole number from 20 years old and upward, which have murmured against me." Now, when they were under 20 years, God didn't hold them responsible. Is 20 the age of accountability? I don't know. I'm merely suggesting it's much older than a great many people seem to think today. And I think this boy Samuel was in his teens. Now, God calls him to salvation. The question has always been, would God have called him a fifth time, a sixth time, a seventh time, or a 50th time? Well, I don't know. I do believe this, that with all my heart, that there is a time to be saved. It's been expressed like this. There is a time, I know not when, a place I know not where, which marks the destiny of man to heaven, our despair. How long may man go on in sin? How long will God forbear? Where does hope end? And where begins the confines of despair? One answer from those skies is sent. Ye who from God depart, while it is called today, repent, and harden not your heart. It's quite interesting, friends, that there will come a day when apparently men don't seem to be able to turn to God. The chaplain that was at the prison where Hermann Goering was placed at the time of his trial and then when he was to be executed, he went in and had a long interview with Goering, and he put before him, as he wrote it later, the necessity of preparing himself to meet God. And he says, in the course of our conversation, he ridiculed certain Bible truths and refused to accept that Christ died for sinners. It was a conscious denial of the power of the blood. "Death is death," was the substance of his last words. As I recall to him the hope of his little daughter to meet him in heaven, he replied, "She believes in her manner and I in mine." Then this man left, very much discouraged, and he says in less than an hour, he heard that Hermann Goering had committed suicide. May I say to you that God called to this man twice, and I think he'll call maybe many times to you. But there apparently comes a day when a man is hardened. And so this is a tremendous lesson.